Hello, and welcome to Teach Engineering. My name is Ariana, and I'm currently a junior at the University of Colorado Boulder, studying to become a biomedical engineer. Today, we're diving into a topic that's both fascinating and crucial for our future, the greenhouse effect. The greenhouse effect is a natural process that warms the Earth's surface. When the sun's energy reaches the Earth, some of it is absorbed and warms the planet. The Earth then radiates some of this heat back towards space. However, before all this heat can escape into space, it has to pass through the Earth's atmosphere. Imagine this diagram I'm sketching here. The sun sends energy to the Earth, warming it up. Then the Earth tries to send some of this heat back to space, but on its way, this heat encounters gases in the atmosphere. These gases absorb and trap some of the heat, keeping our planet warm enough to support life. We call this process the greenhouse effect because it works similarly to how a greenhouse traps heat to keep plants warm. We actually need these greenhouse gases to maintain a livable climate. Without them, the Earth will be too cold for us to survive. However, there is a balance. If too many greenhouse gases accumulate, too much heat gets trapped, and the Earth becomes too warm. This delicate balance is crucial for maintaining the perfect temperature for life on Earth. So, what happens when we disrupt this balance? Human activities such as burning fossil fuels, deforestation, and industrial processes increase the concentration of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. While having some greenhouse gases is essential, having too many can lead to climate change. This change can result in more extreme weather events like hurricanes and blizzards, and can affect our ability to grow food. Scientists use a term to describe the total amount of greenhouse gases emitted by human activities. A carbon footprint. Each one of us has a carbon footprint, which is the amount of greenhouse gases that are releasing to the Earth due to our daily activities. These activities can range from heating our homes, how we commute, to how much waste we produce. Some emissions are direct, like the exhaust from your car, while others are indirect, like the emissions from the factory that made your TV. Let's consider how we can reduce our emissions. One simple way is recycling. For example, if you recycle your newspaper, it prevents greenhouse gases from being released as the paper decomposes in a landfill. Instead of cutting down more trees, which naturally remove greenhouse gases from the air, the recycled paper is reused. Engineers around the world are developing methods to reduce greenhouse gases emissions. For example, they're creating more efficient renewable energy sources and designing buildings that use less energy. It's essential to reduce our carbon footprints, to reduce the levels of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere to their natural states, ensuring a stable climate for everyone. Reducing our carbon footprint helps keep the climate at a healthy level. By minimizing human-made sources of greenhouse gases, we can avoid natural disasters and extreme temperatures, which can be harmful to people and the environment. Remember, every small step you take to reduce your carbon footprint makes a big difference. Stay curious, stay green, and until next time, keep working towards a healthier planet. To better understand the effect of greenhouse gases, check out the associated activity, It's Really Heating Up in Here, on the Teach Engineering website.